Hello?
Hello. I'm Alex.
And I'm Jacob.
And welcome to night one of Music in Our School celebration. Tonight we'll have three groups performing, the first of which is the Percussion Ensemble, and then Belvoir will sing, and then we'll close it out with the Zephyr Wind Orchestra.
All right. Just a couple concert etiquette reminders. Try to stay off your phone, no flash photography. If you gotta leave for whatever reason, try and do it in between songs. And yeah, just enjoy the show.
Mm-hmm. We gotta introduce the songs, man. Okay, we got three songs the Percussion Ensemble is gonna play. First of which is Funky Buckets. That's why we got the trash cans and the buckets from, where's that, Fleet Farm. And then we're gonna have a special visit from Rockin' Ricky Rocket Jr. And then we're gonna close things out with Pharaoh's Pursuit, which is using like percussion instruments back there. Introducing the Percussion Ensemble.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the stage as we welcome the undisputed champion of middleweight drumming, weighing in at 160 pounds, hailing from Matavidi, Minnesota, standing 6'5", Rockin' Ricky Rocket Jr.
Boom, boom.
Man, he's good. He's really good. Da dum 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 da dum
I'm Greta Nelson, and we are the choir co-presidents, and we just want to thank you so much for coming again and supporting our choir and bands. It means a lot to us. We all have worked really hard to put on a good show for you tonight. I hope you've enjoyed it so far.
So this concert that you're here tonight for is the Music in Our School Months concert, which is, you might be wondering, why is it called that? Because 39 years ago, some organization, I think it's to do with the with music education, created the Music in Our Schools Month so that they would raise awareness so that we could understand why music education is so important. And then as a part of that, Mata Meet, I decided we're gonna do a concert between the band and the choir so that the band kids can hear what the choir's working on and the choir kids can hear what the band's working on. And then we can all come together as a music department, get it, Music in Our Schools Month, as a school to just like support one another and know that there's other music being made, sometimes just across the hallway.
And specifically for this concert, we wanted to do a theme of mental health, which will be shown through the songs that the choir will be singing. And each person that will come to speak for the songs will give a little bit of that, like say like, oh, how does this affect, and all that stuff.
Yeah, and as I'm sure you could see with the magical projector that just came out of nowhere, our choirs worked on slides that we're gonna play as we sing so that there's a little bit of information to look at there. We did that as part of our Monday bonding, which is the thing we do every Monday. And a reminder, tomorrow we have another Music in Our Schools Month concert with the Thursday Jazz Band, the Concert Choir, and Zephyr Wind Ensemble. So come back for that tomorrow. You're 50% there by coming tonight.
And without further ado, let's hand the mic off to our Bellevue manager, Charlotte, who will be announcing our first song.
Thank you.
Our first song is called Do Not Ask Me to Remember. It is composed by Christopher Usbas and it focuses on a poem by Owen Darnell that talks about the struggles of dementia, including confusion, struggles with memory, and mood changes. The poem starts off by saying, "Do not ask me to remember. Don't try to make me understand. Let me rest and know you're with me. Kiss my cheek and hold my hand." Owen Darnell wrote this poem after his wife's declining condition with Alzheimer's. And he wanted to write this poem to help people understand the effects of Alzheimer's on the recipients and their close loved ones. This is Do Not Ask Me to Remember.
Thank you. am one of the stage managers for our choir, and the next song we're singing is called Flight, composed by Craig Cornelia and arranged by Dr. Ryan Murphy, and not the Ryan Murphy you're probably thinking about. Written in 1992, this piece takes us through a journey of imagination and freeing your mind, and it's been performed by many recognizable names in the musical theater world, including Sutton Foster and Ben Platt, because Craig Cornelia is known for his work in musical theater composition.
I'm Taylor, I'm the social media manager. Our next song is What Happens When a Woman Takes Power. It's a song about woman empowerment, by Alexandra Alseski of Armstamia. Alexandra said this is a song for strong women of our world who seek to empower themselves by asking important questions. Charlotte Houston, where's Charlotte? There's Charlotte. Taught us the body percussion that helps emphasize the power the women have. The soloists are Charlotte, Ada, Eliana, and Danielle.
Takes power. What happens when she won't back down? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens? What happens? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens when she won't back down? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens? What happens? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens when she won't back down? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens when she wears the crown?
What happens when she moves her own body?
What happens when she sets the beat?
What happens when she bows to nobody?
What happens when she stands on her own two feet? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens when she won't back down? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens? What happens? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens when she won't back down? What happens when a woman takes power? What happens when she wears the crown?
Present-elects for choir next year. Somos Fuerte, Somos Cynthia is a Spanish piece composed by Julio Morales with lyrical excerpts from the poem Woman Against Violence, written by Mariel Elena Lara. It portrays the violence that women face in their everyday lives. It was originally composed for our MHS Belvoir Choir in 2019, and due to COVID was not performed until 2022. Since our choir loves the song so much, we persuaded Mr. Garles to let us sing it once again. The soloists in this piece will be Lauren Gomez, Maya Daniels, and myself. We hope you enjoy Somos Fuerte, Somos Cynthia.
Somos Fuerte, Somos Cynthia. Al mundo mover podemos. Que se escuche la frecuencia. Mujeres juntas gritemos, ya basta de la violencia. Somos fuerte, somos ciencia. Escuchen
Good evening. I am Connor, the ZWO representative.
And I'm Ishna, the band co-president.
Welcome to the third and final portion of tonight's concert, the Zephyr Wind Orchestra.
The Wind Orchestra consists of mostly freshmen, several sophomores, and some juniors. They're excited to play a wide variety of music in their four pieces tonight.
The theme of the concerts over these two nights are ups and downs in life, the struggles mentally, and how to overcome them.
And that journey begins by looking at the stars.
This piece was commissioned by the Association for Music in International Schools. The 2010 Asian Middle School Honor Band in Shanghai, China. The composer, Travis Cross, briefly considered writing a piece on Chinese folklore, but instead focused on the varied nature of the commissioning ensemble, talented student musicians from international schools.
The title comes from a quote by Oscar Wilde that is on a statue of the great author in London with the inscription, "We are all in the gutter, but some of us are looking at the stars."
No matter how old or young we are, or where in the world we may be, when we turn our eyes upward, we are all looking at the stars.
Please welcome the Zephyr Wind Orchestra and their conductor, Miss Laura Goucher.
Thank you. Hello. Our next song is Kachina Spirit and Dance by Anne McGinty. Kachinas are basically spirits and other supernatural beings that are known by the Indian Pueblo villages and people. And this song is more as a ceremonial dance and the music for it, but converted into a band to be spread to the wider audience. Usually it's for different weather events and connecting to the gods, but please enjoy chant and spirit dance.
Okay, a couple of quick announcements from me. Thank you so much for being here tonight. We really appreciate it on behalf of the music teachers here at the high school. We're just really thankful to have a great audience here to help us celebrate music making in our schools, which we're really proud of with all of our groups. And with that, we would love you to share the love. Outside on the table, there's a box that says compliments box on it. You can't miss it, it's sparkly. And we would love you to write a compliment for a band, a percussion group, a choir, or particular members. And all we ask is you write a note, fold it, and on the outside of it, just write what group it's going to so we know we can easily distribute it and get it out for us to read and share the love with these kids after the fact. And before our last two pieces here tonight, we want to talk briefly about our current music fundraiser. First of all, thank you to all of you who have donated already. We have just 48 hours left to raise even more money for our band and our choir departments, and we invite you to scan the QR code for the prospective group you want to donate to and donate it on behalf of your favorite band or choir member. You can find the QR code in several places. It's on each of the doors when you leave. It's on the table outside, and it will be on the video for about a minute. During the credits, you're going to see the QR codes clearly highlighted with which group they're for. We would love you to just scan it, and if you feel so moved, to donate to your favorite band or choir member. And I just want to give a shout out. Molly Rutger, freshman, created this video for you to enjoy.
Hi, I'm Molly, reporter of everything and your host for today's show. Do you want the band and choir kids to have new instruments to play? Yay! Guest conductors and get-together events? Yay! Look no further than the fundraising marvel of the kindness of friends and family. Join me today as we take a look at this fundraiser.
Oh no, a distressed person. We better interview her ASAP. What is distressing you?
It's so sad. We need more money for fundraising.
Well, never fear. We happen to have a QR code here that this generous audience can use to donate money to.
Really? Simply take out your phone, go to your camera app, raise it to the QR code on the screen, and tap on the link when it appears.
Then fill out the form. Be sure to check the rest of that page.
What is your favorite part about band? Or choir?
Or choir.
I like that you're able to work with people, and I like that you're able to like see yourself improve.
I love the community. I think it's a very strong community of people to come together and make music.
How have guest conductors helped you?
They help us see the music in a different way because we don't have the same person working on it with us, so they help us focus on different things.
Caitlin, how is having school instruments available beneficial to the music students at MHS?
It's beneficial because it gives students a chance to learn a new instrument without having to like fully commit and go rent one from a store or go buy one. For me personally, even though it's my senior year, I really wanted to learn tenor sax, and Gelcher goes, we have two new tenor saxes for the school that you could use to learn it, and now I've gotten to learn it, and it's been amazing, and I didn't have to actually go out and buy one and rent one, even though now I'm going to, because I know I want to keep playing that instrument.
What's your favorite part of band or choir?
My favorite part of band is I just like the final moment we all play together, and it's like, oh my god, we sound so good. And my favorite moment of choir is like when we don't sing, we're all just hanging out together, and we're just like having fun.
All aboard!
Thank you for considering donating and just for helping out the music department. We really appreciate it. And with that, we're going to switch gears completely from that to what we're going to do next. Our next piece is going to be introduced by the composer himself. He's not actually here. They got excited when I said Randall Standridge was going to introduce the piece, but he's not actually here. But he has a really great video introducing this piece. So please enjoy the introduction from Randall Standridge.
Hello, my name is Randall Standridge, and I am the composer of the work you are about to hear, Not Alone. Not Alone was created through a consortium of over 300 schools and organizations who came together to support the creation of a piece of art that would further and represent discussions about mental health conditions. In this work, you will hear some dark moments at the beginning, starting with a solo voice with a bittersweet melody, representing an individual living with such conditions. The piece devolves into a moment of profound despair, anger, and fear as the individual reaches their lowest point. However, at the ending, the original melody returns as the individual has received the help they needed and truly realized that they are not alone. We hope this work will provoke discussions about mental health conditions and also perhaps encourage those of you that might be secretly suffering with such conditions to seek the help you need. Please know that you are not alone and that happiness and help is possible. I want to thank all of the organizations who have come together to support this work. And speaking as a person who lives with depression and anxiety myself, I hope that we can tear down the taboos and make discussing mental health normal. Thank you for your time. I hope you enjoy the piece. And as always, peace, love, and music.
Hi, I'm Molly, the ninth grade rep, and the final piece of the night is a piece by 24-year-old composer Adrian Sims. It is called Inspiration Fanfare. Inspiration can arise from anywhere imaginable and can be present at any given moment. This work was inspired by the melody presented in the opening statement, which came to composer Sims while walking the neighborhood trail on a sunny morning. He heard this melody and immediately felt uplifted by its presence. Joy and opportunity prevail throughout the work, and its cheerful spirit persists ever onward, shining brightly into the distant future. Thank you for coming to tonight's concert. We want to invite all of you back tomorrow night at 7 p.m. for part two of our Music in the Schools concert celebrations, where you will hear from the Zephyr Jazz Ensemble, Concert Choir, and the Zephyr Wind Ensemble.